Brothers, I post this thread today as a call to arms. For too long, the corporate fat cats have stepped on us. For too long, the working man has been oppressed by his superiors. We shall stand it no longer. We shall seize the means of production, and we will do it by force. Anyone who stands in our way shall be beaten to death. Because when we band together, we can take down any foe. We are strong together, comrades. Together, we will take down capitalism. And send.
Sir, you are holding the rest of the line. Can you please order?
Yeah, sorry about that. I was just telling my Twitter followers how capitalism needs to be destroyed. Anyway, I'll have a venti cinnamon dulce latte with soy milk.
Yeah, I didn't ask about what you were tweeting. Take your coffee and stop holding everyone else up.
Thank you. Ow, 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 too hot, I burned my tongue. Ow, owie, ow.
I don't get paid enough for this shit.
Welcome back to Internet Annoyances. I'm Mike Osiris, and in an older video, I expressed my distaste for politics. The actions of certain political parties leading up to the 2020 election just left a bad taste in my mouth, and I wanted to distance myself from it all. But there is one political belief system that I kept consistently making fun of because it was that retarded. When you make both sides of the American political parties look level-headed in comparison, that's how you know you fucked up royally. I'm talking, of course, about communism. You know, the system that failed every single time it was tried. Multiple refugees from third world communist dictatorships will tell you how much their lives got fucked up as a result of it, and yet you still get these upper class white kids from dipshit university who have never experienced any hardship in their lives telling anyone who will listen how communism is not evil and is in fact the way of the future. That's who I've got my sights set on today. Dumbass communists on the internet who have no sense of how the world works and no knowledge of basic world history. If you have any booze on hand, now's your opportunity to down the bottle because this is gonna be a rough one. Part 1. What is communism? So, to understand why communism is an inherently awful idea, we'll have to review the basics of it. Communism is an idea brought to life by Karl Marx, and is an offshoot of his main ideas of Marxism. Marxism calls for two main things: dismantling social classes, in theory making everyone equals, and dismantling the government, making sure that there are no corrupt shit stains trying to plant their boots on the necks of the working class. Keep that second one in mind. So, when communism was being peddled back when it was first thought up, and was gaining traction, there were multiple rulers who adopted these ideas. Well, if you want to be accurate here, they kinda forgot about the second thing I referred to earlier, and took advantage of the useful morons who called for communism to be the law of the land. You see, the term communist government was supposed to be a fucking oxymoron, since having any government at all was 100% contradictory to Marx's ideology, and this went about as well as you could expect. Communist nations turned into absolute utopias where there was no crime, no killing, no sickness, no famine, and everyone was happy.
Wow, really, Uncle Osiris?
No, not really, you fucking idiot! These nations under communism had nothing but death, corruption, famine, and governmental oppression. Joseph Stalin had an interesting hobby where he would kill and erase the existences of people who talked shit about the USSR and its leaders. Soviet streets were lined with emaciated dead bodies since everybody was starving to death. Why? Oh, only because the government seized the crops of all the farmers. Because if everyone's starving, they're too weak to fight back. Now, you might be thinking, but Mike, how do you even know all of this? Well, it's simple, really. All I had to do to discover these facts was pay attention in my 10th grade history class. But evidently, not everyone has done this, since there are many people online who, regardless of having access to this information with the clicks of a few buttons, still choose to push for communism in first world countries. Let's have a look in part 2, the Tankies of Twitter. I just find it hilariously ironic that the main efforts for pushing communism are being done on Twitter from smartphones. You know, two things that would have never fucking existed if it wasn't for capitalism. Despite the lack of self-awareness regarding that, the Tankies are still adamant about their beliefs. This first guy thought he was being clever. Can't live without communism, huh? Yeah, that's weird, since there are millions of people in the Soviet Union in the 1930s who sure as shit couldn't live with communism, considering they all fucking starved to death after their government took all the crops away. Also, how much you want to bet that this guy never lived in a communist shithole a day in his life? Up next, we have someone who doesn't understand that people can be forced into doing shit. Sure, these things can still be constructed under communism. However, it'll be done very shittily, and it'll be done at gunpoint, considering the workers need some compensation to keep working, and if it can't be money, it'll be fear of death. Wait, what was the word for that concept again? Oh, right. It was fucking slavery. This third one wasn't trying to make an argument, but I just wanted to bring up that Stalin hated gay people, and they were some of the first that he threw in the gulags, so I'm seeing a bit of a conflict of interest here. But maybe not, though. With all the sodomy that happens in prisons, maybe it worked out for the gay guys after all. 5 years of hard labor probably took a whole new meaning to them. Ah, yes. When in doubt, shift the blame. Whataboutism is fucking stupid. Sure, the US did some absolutely rotten shit in the past, but that's not the point at hand here. Just because there are other bad things, that doesn't make your thing any less bad. But guess what? I have more room to talk than you, Mr. Chinese government official, since I don't contribute to the suffering of countless Uyghurs every day, unlike you. Okay, I'm done looking through that cesspool. If you think looking at these tweets alone was bad, at least you didn't have to look for them like I did. I feel like absolute shit now. Hey, you know what would calm my nerves? A nice helicopter ride. And you Tankies can even come with me. I know your type has been keen on helicopter rides in the past. Part 3. So you want to be a communism. Being a communist is as easy as getting thrown off of a rooftop in Iran, and all you have to do for that is just being gay. But seriously, it's easy being a communist. Once you learn the tricks for debating others on the internet, it'll be impossible to argue against you. So, with a few tips from Professor Mykov Osirisevich, you'll be as retarded, red-pilled, as the rest of us. Tip number one, replace your brain with a pile of dog shit. Good communists don't have thinking as their strong suit, since if you think about communism even a little, you can see how it would backfire easily. So, stop having coherent thoughts. The best way to ensure this is to find your nearest mechanic and bash yourself a couple of times over the head with a monkey wrench. It's hard to think clearly when you have severe brain damage, and a stupid communist is a good communist. Tip number two, deflection and denial go a long way. When arguing against anti-communists, you can expect them to bring up all those pesky deaths and atrocities committed by communist governments. I know. Who gives a shit about that, right? Well, we can't have them thinking about that for too long, so immediately change the subject to something that their country did that isn't even remotely fucking comparable to the hundreds of millions that communism has killed. Also, deny the Uyghur concentration camps set up by the Chinese. They are there willingly, and it's all just one big summer camp. Tip number 3. Don't have the argument on lock, just block. Like God King Stalin himself, we have the power to pretend our detractors don't exist. When you think you are losing the argument, just fucking block them. Most, if not all, social media sites have this feature, so take advantage of it. You can't have them putting their ideas of human rights into your head now. That's just crazy talk. It's not losing the argument if it never formally finished, so you'll still be undefeated in your own heart. Tip number 4. Acquire a taste for shoe polish, because we are doing some serious boot licking. Just like those who blindly defended Derek Chauvin during the trial, we are gonna lick some serious bootage. Find anyone who is even remotely right-leaning compared to Marx, and be sure to give them hell. Our dictators, leaders, will appreciate it. Trust me, comrade, it'll never come back to bite you in the ass one day. I promise. And that's pretty much all you need to know if you want to be an online communist. Now get out there and make flat earthers look smarter by default. Imagine thinking you know more about communism than someone who has actually lived through it and escaped that country looking for a better home. Imagine lacking the self-awareness to realize how hypocritical it is to shill for communism on the newest iPhone. Imagine advocating for a system that has failed literally every single time it was tried, and then saying it wasn't real communism when the new communist utopia of the hour inevitably fails. Imagine thinking that you are the one who is right, then turning around and blocking everyone you've argued with on Twitter for the high crime of disagreeing with you. It couldn't be me, because if I did that shit, I'd be a spineless communist, and that would make me another internet annoyance. I'm Mike Osiris, and I'm going back under.
Subscribe to Mike Osiris, or else I will use the world to freeze time and steal a bitch. See you in the next Virgil, you pathetic waste of space. Yes, sir.